Okay, Shalom. And as always, we begin with giving praise to the Most High, the Creator of heaven and earth, for giving us another opportunity to come together in these last days to deliver the message for all those that are seeking truth in these last days. What we're touching on today is we're going to revive the topic of the pork deception. We went over 1 Timothy 4 verse 4 in the first pork deception video, and the majority of people that watched it, they understood the concept of it. So about 90% of people that watched it, they got the concept. They say, okay, I understand, we're not supposed to be eating pork. But then you had the other 10% who don't want to understand it. It's not that they couldn't understand it, it's that they don't want to understand it. And their job from thenceforward is to get those that understood it out of the realm of understanding and to bring them back into the lust of eating the pork. So they're going to pull out scriptures, this scripture that we're going to go over, the Matthew 15 verse 11. They're going to pull out little scriptures like this to see how many people they can catch in the net. Because it was too clear that 1 Timothy 4 verse 4 is not talking about eating pork. So they're going to bring out, they're going to try their luck with Matthew 15 verse 11 and see how many people fall for it. Why? Because these people are more subtle than any beast of the field. They're dealing with Satan. So their job is not to understand and bring out truth, it's to try to catch as many people as possible and bring you back into wickedness. Because they're not gonna change regardless. And no matter how many scriptures you bring out, there's certain people that are stuck in their ways. They're not gonna change regardless of what scripture you bring out. It doesn't matter. The Most High says in the scriptures, what the Most High has made a bent, no man can straighten. So if the Most High made someone crooked, you can't straighten that person out. You just have to beware of the wiles of Satan. Because a lot of these people are more subtle than any beast of the field. So now they're taking Matthew 15 verse 11 and they're going to present it to you and say, see, Brother Yarashalam's lying about this pork deception thing. Christ says, no matter what goes into your mouth, that doesn't defile you. So that means we can eat the pork, the alligator, the elephants, the giraffes. We can eat anything we want because that doesn't defile us. And what you're going to find out is that this scripture has nothing to do with eating food. That's what we're going to go through. We're going to go through the correct context because you're going to need this ammunition. This video is not for the 10% that don't want to understand or however many percent that don't want to understand. It's not for them. It's for the people that are sincere, that really want to partake in righteousness. You're going to need some type of ammunition to combat the people that are presenting these scriptures to you, that picking these little scriptures out of context and presenting them to you. You're going to need ammunition. So these videos are for you. It's not for the people who are stuck in their ways. You just need something to fan them off and say, listen, this ain't talking about that. Or so you don't get confounded and stuck when they try to present this to you. So without further ado, we're about to get into it. I'm Brother Yarashalam. This is the Bible Unlocked, the Pork Deception, Part 2. Not that which goeth into the mouth defileth the man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth the man. Boom, here you go right here. See, this is what they present to you. Say, see, that Brother Yarashalam, he's trying to tell you that you can't eat the pork. But Jesus right here is saying, it doesn't matter what comes into your mouth. It only matters what goes out of your mouth. So we can eat the pork, roaches, snails, we can eat whatever we want because that doesn't defile us. So they make you believe that the part that comes into your mouth, when he says that which cometh into your mouth, they'll make you believe that this is only talking about food. This can't be talking about something else. This is talking about food. And then you ask them, so what is it that comes out of your mouth that defiles a man? And then they'll give you every other example other than food. They'll say, oh, that's talking about cuss words and everything. They'll give you a whole list. But the one that came into your mouth, that wasn't talking about anything else other than food. This is why I say that you're dealing with people that are more subtle than any beast of the field. So now what we're going to do, we're going to start from the beginning of the context because this is the kryptonite to people who use scriptures out of context. This is the kryptonite. We're going to go in the context and we're going to read places where they don't want to go. Because it's going to reveal that they're really more subtle than any beast of the field. That's what it's going to really reveal, that they're dealing with Satan. So that's how we're going to break this down. I can go to three verses in this chapter and show you off top that this is not talking about it. I can get to the three quick main verses and show you that this has nothing to do with that. But we're going to go through the context so everyone can get their clear understanding, so there's no one who's going to come by and try to present this verse and you not know how to deal with it. So let's go. Matthew chapter 15, verse 1. Then came to Jesus scribes and Pharisees, which were of Jerusalem, saying, "Why do thy disciples transgress the traditions of the elders? For they wash not their hands when they eat bread." So this is the scenario being presented. You have Christ, and then you have the scribes and Pharisees approaching him, and they're presenting him with a question. They're trying to hit him up. They're saying, "Why are your disciples transgressing or breaking the traditions of the elders? Because what we do is we wash our hands before we eat." So this is the main setting of the chapter. "But he answered and said unto them," but Jesus answered and said unto the scribes and Pharisees, "Why do ye also transgress the commandment of God by your traditions?" Christ flipped it back on them. He didn't answer their question. He says, "Why are you breaking the Most High's laws and replacing them with your traditions?" Sound familiar? He says, "Why are you doing that? Answer this question first before we go in any further. For God commanded, saying, honor thy father and mother, and he that curseth father or mother, let him die the death." Christ is giving you what the Most High says. Honor thy mother and thy father, and whoever curses the mother or father, the judgment was he should be put to death. That's what Christ is quoting. "But ye say, whosoever shall say to his father or his mother, it is a gift, by whatsoever thou mightest be profited by me, and honor not his father or his mother, he shall be free." But you, the scribes and Pharisees, you're teaching something totally different than what the Most High said. So while you're coming and trying to hit me up or try to rebuke me for not keeping your commandments or your traditions, meanwhile, on the other hand, you're not doing anything that the Most High said. This is the dilemma that's going on. He said, you're not doing nothing that the Most High says. So you got some nerve trying to ask me why I'm not keeping the traditions of the elder and not washing why the disciples aren't washing their hands before they get a bite to eat. "Thus have ye made the commandment of God of none effect by your traditions." And you've made the commandments of God, you've done away with them, and you replaced them with your own traditions. Sound familiar? You say we don't have to keep honor thy mother and thy father and the judgment that comes behind it. We're just going to replace it with what we feel believes should be there. That's what the scribes and Pharisees were doing. Sound familiar? "Ye hypocrites, well did Isaiah prophesy of you, saying, this people draw nigh unto me with their mouth and honoreth me with their lips." With their mouth, they say they love the Most High. To give you all type of lip service on how much they love the Most High, how beautiful he's been to them, how much they admire the Most High. They do all this stuff with the lip service, but their heart is far from me. But they won't do anything that the Most High commanded. The thoughts of their mind are far from the Most High. They really want to replace the Most High's commandments with their traditions. That's what was going on right now. They really want to get rid of what the Most High says and replace them with what they feel should be there. They'll tell you that they love him all day, but they won't do nothing that he says. Sound familiar? "But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men." The commandments of men is what the Pharisees were teaching. That commandment of men was washing hands before eating. That was what the Pharisees were teaching. This is the problem that Christ had with the Pharisees. It wasn't that they were teaching the law and telling everyone to be righteous. It was that they were substituting the Most High's commandments for their commandments. They were being hypocrites. This is the problem he had with the scribes and Pharisees. Most people have this totally wrong about the role of the scribes and Pharisees. It's not because they were teaching the law. They were being hypocrites. That's what was going on. And he called the multitude and said unto them, hear and understand. So now Christ gathered the multitude together and says, come and listen to what I'm about to say and understand what I'm about to say. Not that which goeth into the mouth defileth the man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth the man. As we continue reading, then we're going to get the complete understanding on what he was talking about. Nowhere in this context do we see anything about eating a pork sandwich. The subject matter was not, why are thy disciples eating a pork sandwich? Or why are thy disciples eating a horse thighs? Or why are thy disciples eating octopus legs or tentacles or squids? That wasn't in the context. Let's continue. Then came his disciples and said unto him, knowest thou that the Pharisees were offended after they heard this saying? Then the disciples came to Christ and says, don't you know that the scribes and Pharisees were offended after this, after they heard this saying? Letting you know that that what Christ just said applied to the scenario with the scribes and Pharisees. It wasn't some random outbreak and he just randomly saying, we can eat whatever we want, that don't defile us. What he said applied to the scenario and what the dialogue between the scribes and Pharisees. That's how they understood it. They knew he wasn't saying, just talking out of his behind. That what he just said applied to what was going on with the scribes and Pharisees. This is simple, in context. But he answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father have not planted shall be rooted up. Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind, and if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. That's why you have to be careful with the people that you're following. Because if the blind lead the blind, you're both falling in the ditch. There's not going to be any excuse for the person, for the leader or the follower. You both get the same punishment. That's why it's very dangerous following people teaching you don't keep the commandments. If they don't get anything else right on any other breakdowns, as long as they get the commandment part right, then you're good. Keep the commandments. Don't follow idolatry. Don't be doing paganism. Keep the commandments. Follow Christ. You're good no matter what. It don't matter if they can't break down Revelations or they can't break down Genesis. It don't matter any of that. If they telling you to keep the commandments, follow Christ, then you're good. Once they step out of that element, now you're playing Russian roulette. And if you blind lead the blind, like Christ was saying, they were doing away with God's commandments and replacing them with their own. If the blind lead the blind, you're both falling in the ditch. There's no excuse on the day of judgment. There's no excuse. Then answered Peter, one of the 12 disciples, and said unto the Messiah, declare unto us this parable. Now your faith is about to get tested on what you believe. Now we're about to get into the deep water. It's time to sink or swim now. This is the part that the Christian church or any of the other people teaching that Matthew 15:11 was talking about eating pork and you can eat whatever you want. This is where they don't want you to go. They want you to stick to Matthew 15 verse 11 so they can persuade you and move your mind to wherever they want it to go. Now, as we continue reading, we find out that Peter understood what he said in Matthew 15 verse 11 about what goes into the mouth doesn't defile you, but what comes out, that's what defiles you. He understood that to be a parable. Meaning, Christ didn't mean what he said. It didn't mean literally. He didn't take that, when he said it, it wasn't something to be taken literally. He wasn't saying, because if you took it literally, that means you can eat cardboard boxes, plastic, or whatever, steel, metal, you can eat anything because it won't defile you. Peter knew not to take that literally. So he says, declare unto us this parable. Now I'm sure 100% that nobody over here had more understanding than Peter. I don't care how long you've been into a theologian school, how many times you went over the scriptures, you didn't have more understanding than Peter because Peter was right there when the scenario cracked off. So if Peter understood it to be a parable, you should understand it to be a parable as well. Because we don't have more understanding than Peter, who was right there, taught by Christ. So now let's read further and get the understanding of this parable. And let's find out if it's talking about pork, shrimp, crab, and lobster, and unclean meats, or if it's talking about something else. And Jesus said, are ye also without understanding? Are you also without understanding? You don't understand what I'm trying to bring out? You can't understand this small, simple parable that I'm bringing forth? That's what he said to Peter. Do not ye yet understand that whatsoever entereth in at the mouth goeth in into the belly and is cast out into the draught? But those things which proceeded out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile the man. For out of the heart proceedeth evil thoughts. Evil thoughts come out of the heart. Murderers, trying to find out how you can go and kill your neighbor or your brother because he's wearing a different color than you, or because his culture is different than yours, or because he doesn't think the same way you think, finding some way you can go ahead and kill him, or because maybe he's progressing in life and the Most High has blessed him with more substance than you have. Thinking of ways you can go and murder someone. Adulteries, thinking about how you can sleep with another man's wife. How they promote on the rap videos here in America that it's cool for you to get out there and sleep with other people's wives, and how they promote it and push it on everyone and have everybody thinking that that's the normal thing to do. That's what defiles you, which goes back to the commandments. Fornication, thinking about how you can sleep with animals, how you can sleep with your sister or sleep with your mother or your father. This is something that defiles you. This is in the commandment, and fornication is not in the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt not commit fornication is not in the Ten Commandments. This is going back to the law. This is what Christ is quoting. That's gonna defile you, breaking that commandment or breaking that law. Thefts, thinking about how you can go out and rob people for their countries and then push them out of the country and then call them illegal aliens, thinking about how you can do that and devising more plans to go inside other people's countries and rob them for their natural resources so you can become multi-billionaires and trillionaires. Thefts, that's what will defile a man. False witness, saying that the people living over there in the land of Israel are the real Jews, and saying that the people over here in America who came over here in slavery are black people and African Americans and Negroes, false witness. Blasphemy, trying to teach that Matthew 15 verse 11 was talking about Christ is given the stamp of approval for you to go out there and go eat on a rib sandwich. Or go out there and eat on a pig in the blanket. That's blasphemies. These are the things which defileth a man. These things are what is going to make you defiled. These are the things that will defile you, not keeping the Most High's commandments. But to eat with unwashing hands, but to what? But to eat with unwashing hands, no, but to eat any abominable food that the Most High said we can't eat in Leviticus the 11th chapter. But to eat with unwashing hands, but to eat without washing your filthy, disgusting hands, defileth not a man. These defile not a man. Going right back into the context of the chapter. When the Pharisees asked Christ, why do your disciples transgress the commandments of the elders? Because we wash our hands before eating. This is what the parable was talking about. It didn't have anything to do with eating a rib, McRib sandwich, or going out and eating elephant tusk, or going out and eating donkey ankles. It didn't have anything to do with that at all. But to eat with unwashing hands, that won't defile you. That's what Christ is saying. It's not a sin to, if a man come inside, if he's been working outside all day and he come in and he just grab a sandwich and don't wash his hands. There's no way in the commandments that the Most High says, thou shalt not eat unless thou hast washed thy hands. That's a commandment of the Pharisees and the scribes. The Most High didn't institute that commandment. So he's saying that's not gonna defile you, because that's why he says whatever comes in, if it's dirt, germs, any type of bacteria, all it is gonna do is just get washed down the your stomach, and it's gonna come out when you use the bathroom. That's not a big deal. This didn't have anything to do with slapping your lips on the pork sandwich. Nothing at all to do with that. So now, the people who are more subtle than any beast of the field, you can't use that. We done took this verse back now. This scripture no longer belongs to you, Satan. It no longer belongs to Satan. We know this has nothing to do with eating pork. This is talking about washing hands. The whole context was talking about washing hands and eating without your hands being washed. And the traditions of the scribes and Pharisees. Satan can no longer use this. Now let's go find out, to those that are more subtle than any beast of the field, we're going to find out what you have to look forward to. Because there's a prophecy that is made just for you, the ones that of you that are stuck in your ways and going to continue even after we just clearly went through what this scripture meant. You're still going to be stuck in your ways, and you're going to go try to search for other scriptures to bring out to justify the lust of eating pork. There's a section of the Bible for you. This is what you have to look forward to while you enjoy the lust of your pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, any other clean, unclean meat that you want to desire. Watch. Isaiah 66 verse 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind. This is talking about the Most High getting ready to come and invade the earth, to come see what the children of men are up to. The Most High is returning with fire and with his chariots to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. And obviously the Most High is upset about something. There's something going on down here with the children of men that the Most High is not too happy with, because he's coming back rebuking. That means correcting. Something's not on course with the way he set it up, and he don't like it. So when he comes back to invade, he's coming back with fury and flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh. And when he returns to invade the earth, he's not sitting down with Congress and signing papers and coming up with new legislation. The Most High is not sitting down and making treaties. For by fire and by his sword is the way he's going to plead with all flesh. He's not sitting down signing contracts. The contract is already in place already. The contract was the scriptures and the commandments that he put in place. That was the contract. Now he's coming to see if the contract is being fulfilled. And obviously it has not been fulfilled. Somebody's not keeping their end of the bargain. And the Most High is definitely keeping his. So obviously we're not, the people down here on earth aren't keeping their end of the bargain. And the slain of the Lord shall be many. He's going to kill many. A lot of people are going to die when the Most High breaks through the atmosphere. It didn't say a few people, it said many. Many, many, many. Many people are going to die. Now we're going to find out who is part of this many people who's going to die. That's what we're going to find out right now. Because somebody has to die. The prophecy's already written. Somebody has to fulfill this portion. Somebody's already selected for this portion to get put to death. Let's find out who's on the list. They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the garden behind one tree in the midst. Those that sanctify themselves and make themselves clean, when the Most High said something was not clean, they took it upon themselves to say, I'm gonna make it clean myself. They that do that, eating swine's flesh, eating what? Eating swine's flesh. When the Most High cracks the atmosphere and he catch you sitting down at lunchtime, talking about, I want my baby back, chilies, baby back ribs, barbecue sauce. He catch you eating the swine's flesh and the abomination and the rest of the abominations that the Most High said in the Leviticus, the 11th chapter, that you're not supposed to be eating, like cockroaches, lizards, snakes, snails, octopus, shark, whales, pigeons, vultures. And any of the rest of the abominations that the Most High said that the children of Israel are not supposed to be eating, and the mouse, and the nasty mouse. I don't know who would slap their lips on the nasty mouse, but obviously there's someone out there slapping their lips on the nasty mouse. So if the Most High catch you back, come back and catch you eating Master Splinter, you're on the list too. Shall be consumed together. You're going to die together. That's what the prophecy says. Those of you that's stuck in your ways and saying, I'm going to cling on to the pork, you're going to all die together. No, how many, it says, no matter if hand joining hand, no matter how many hands you hold, the whole earth could be holding hands when the Most High come back, holding hands and eating pork. You're all going to die. Everyone's going to die. No hand joining hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished. That's what he says. No matter how many people want to join together and try to make and try to force people to believe that Matthew 15:11 was talking about eating pork. Isaiah lets you know that none of those scriptures from here forth are talking about you can eat pork. None of the scriptures going forth are telling you that you can eat pork, because this prophecy has not come to pass. And the Most High is not a man that he should lie. He says, you all gonna die together, saith the Lord. Say it the Most High, not Brother Yarashalam, or not any other Israelites that are teaching the word in these last days. Say it the Lord. He said it. So I'm not the one you have the issue with. You have the issue with the Most High. And if you continue with that issue with the Most High, he's gonna get the he's gonna be the one who gets the final say so. He's gonna get the last laugh. The Most High is going to get the last laugh. So you can sit down, eat your barbecue pig feet. You can do all that all you want to. The Most High is going to get the last laugh. He's going to come back, catch you putting the pig feet on the grill. And as soon as you taste the pig's feet, you're going to taste death right after. It's a one-for-one swap. You want to eat the pork? You got to eat this death too. And the Most High is coming and put you on his barbecue pit. He's coming to flame broil some humans. That's what he's coming to do. He's coming to show you his barbecue pit. While you're sitting there barbecuing the pork, he's going to sit here and show you his barbecue pit where he's barbecuing a whole congregation of humans. Whole population of, populations of humans is what he's going to be barbecuing. But the difference between his barbecue pit and yours is his don't run out of charcoal. His don't run out. His like the Energizer Bunny. It just keeps burning and burning and burning. And while you might cook your meat on a medium or a medium low, the Most High cook his stuff always on high. The highest level is what he cooks on. The Most High don't want no medium rare or well done. He want burnt. That's what he's looking for. Burnt skins. He's looking for burnt human beings when he comes back. It says with flames of fire is how he's going to be rebuking. It's going to be a lot of living barbecue, human barbecue remains when the Most High is done. So if you want to continue to eat the pork, that's on you. Not my job is not to convince you. It's just to give you the opportunity. The Most High says there's one person that waters, one person that plants, another waters, but the Most High gives the increase. So it don't matter. I can bring the message out, but if the Most High don't pick you for his team, you're not coming on the team. If he don't want you on his team, you're going to continue eating the pork and thinking that's what it means. Thinking that it's okay to eat the pork, shrimp, crab, and lobster, and all the other unclean meats. You're going to keep doing that. If he don't want you on his team, he don't want you. Obviously, somebody got to meet the lake of fire. Somebody has to meet it. It's already reserved for a certain amount of slots. Somebody has to fill those slots. Everyone can't make it to the kingdom. If everyone was to make it to the kingdom, we wouldn't be having this discussion right now. It'd be a different scenario. So now we got the clear breakdown and understanding of Matthew 15:11. So we know for sure that that verse has nothing to do with eating a pork sandwich. It was talking about eating with unwashed hands, the traditions of the scribes and Pharisees versus the commandments. And Christ was just letting them know that it's not against or it's not a sin to eat without washing your hands. That's not going to defile you because you get some germs or you get a little bit of dirt in your mouth. That's not going to defile you. But murdering and sleeping with people's wives and going out and stealing, that's what's going to defile you. Not eating a little piece of dirt because you didn't wash your hands. So we took that verse, that scripture is now belongs to us now. So there's no one who can come along and use it. Now, the brothers and sisters out there, you have the ammunition to fight that battle when they try to come and present it. All you need to do is show them the beginning where it talks about eating with unwashed hands. I think it's verse 2. Then you jump down and show Matthew 15 verse 11 where Christ says it's not what goes into the mouth, but what comes out is what defiles a man. Then you go right and show them that Peter knew that it was a parable. Then you go down and where Christ broke down the parable. That's all you need to do. It's really four scriptures that you need to go to. But we just went through the whole context to give the full understanding through the power and spirit of the Most High. So with that, until next time, I'm Brother Yarashalam, and I say Shalom.